first question I have for you is, how often do people stop you on the street, want to take your photo, and do that iconic Charlie's Angels pose?
All the time. A lot. Yeah, it's iconic. My husband always says there are two images that everybody can relate to and understands and know it immediately. One of them is the thinker, and the other one is the Charlie's Angels pose. And it's kind of true.
And it never gets old. Let's talk about your optimism. This has been, just to sum it up, a very strange 6 months that we've been going through with this pandemic. How do you stay positive and stay smiling during all this?
You know, I just kind of give it to God, because it's going to be over. It's not going to last forever. You know, I've always been a really optimistic person. And but recently, you know, I had to have eye surgery. I had to have my cataracts removed. I knew that my eyes were bad because it was getting to a place where I couldn't drive at night. But indeed, I had cataracts. And what was amazing about it is that I got my eyesight back. I have these trifocal lens put in my eyes. They're called panoptics lenses, and they are unbelievable. I have my eyesight that I had when I was 12. I'm not kidding. It gave me my life back.
I was reading an article about you recently, Cheryl. I know that you love to golf. And years ago, you golfed with Arnold Palmer. You were nervous, and you told yourself, Cheryl, I'm an actress, act like a golfer. How often in life have you had to use that, you know what, Cheryl, fake it till you make it kind of attitude to get through something?
Sometimes when you feel you can't handle something, be an actor and just pretend like you're in this movie and you're going to stand up and do what needs to be done and get it done and go for it. It's helped me a lot in life.
How have you managed to kind of keep your private life private in the age of tabloids and things being online instantly? How have you sort of managed to separate the two?
I'm cautious about how much I get on the computer and what I say and what I do. But I have so many fans, starting with Charlie's Angels. I mean, we all grew up together, so many of us. And, you know, one of the things about Charlie's Angels that I so appreciate is the fact that it gave young women opportunities that they didn't think they had before, and they got to fulfill some dreams and saw themselves doing things that were sort of at that time very unconventional.
What advice can you share with others who are feeling uncertain during this time, not sure what tomorrow will bring, and this pandemic has kind of thrown people through a loop? What can you say?
As my mother said, this is today. This is not necessarily going to be tomorrow. And keeping that optimistic approach and that time, and just often I put that the day in my head where we can hug each other again. We need to love each other and take care of each other and treat each other with respect. And that's very important.